First on Four, music, madness and mayhem in the words Christmas Cracker.
Tonight's show, The Word presents a Christmas cracker full of the best from 1993. We go on location to meet Sylvester Stallone, Jean-Claude Van Damme and Eddie Murphy, visit America's biggest star and chat to their tallest, basketball superstar Shaquille O'Neal. Plus we've got music from Freaky Realistic, Jamiroquai, Stacabo and many more. And don't forget those famous faces on our sofa. All that tonight
on The Word.
The Word.
Good morning, welcome to The Word. And here are two words you're going to be sick of 24 hours from now. Merry Christmas.
That's right, it's now Christmas Day, but only just. In fact, we're about 12 minutes into it, and as all you good children know, you can't open your presents till the sun comes up.
And to stop you raiding your stockings or anyone else's, we've got a very special gift for you, The Word's Christmas Cracker. It's been a roller coaster of a year, and some of the bumpiest rides have been on the sofa. Never you mind, then. Be a bit modest about it. Be a bit modest. That is a very dashing outfit, that Ruth. Can you stand,
like my chest?
Stand up and give us a twirl.
And this is the back.
Oh, I bet you say that to all the drag queens, right?
I think we do, really.
Oh,
get on with it. Get down there.
The great thing about doing the sex program, it's completely democratic. They can't tax you for it. You know, if they could, they would, but they can't. It goes right across the class system. You know, upper class people do it, middle class people do it, but working class people do it better.
I mean, did you used to find it quite embarrassing, the fact that you were an aristocrat when you were at school?
No, not really. No, it wasn't too bad, Dad. It was a bit more difficult in jail, you know.
You know, when you split up with Adam Ant, I mean, obviously, it's not musical differences on that score, but, I mean, did he pack you in or did you pack him in?
I think it was a sort of a mutual kind of admiration and separation at society, yeah.
Did you have a kind of argument, so, like, you know, if you're going down the pub in that pirate outfit, I'm off?
He always used to pinch me makeup.
I remember reading a very good quote of yours a few years ago where you said, I didn't mind the pirate or the warrior look, but I must admit, when I played a Regency dandy, I felt a bit of a prat.
Yeah.
What kind of thing will you be doing now when you're trying, you know, when you're relaunching your career and everything? Will you still go for, like, outrageous looks?
Well, I'd like to dress up for, you know, when I go on stage. I mean, I think a lot of people get a lot of mileage out of just looking like they got out of bed, which is fine, but I like to, you know, wear some good clothes.
I mean, were you an Adam and the Ants fan? Because you were into punk and all that, weren't you?
Yeah, I was into punk, but I was never into Adam or the Ants.
But Adam and the Ants were quite a hardcore punk band, weren't they, at one time?
Oh, yeah.
No, they were. They were in the really early... in the early on days, they were, before Kings of the Wild.
I was a 101ers fan myself, you know.
Well, obviously, people, you know, remember you writing the lyrics for the New Order, World in Motion. That's right, which you originally wanted to call E for England.
That's right, yeah.
And why did they put the blockers on that?
Well, I think it had something to do with the fact that the lyric went, E is for England, England starts with E, we'll all be smiling, not just in Italy. I think at the time there were certain drug-related overtones.
Well, good to
Mr.
See you.
Bob Holness, top genial TV celebrity.
Good to see you.
Well, what we're going to try and do is what GMTV would normally call a makeover.
I was going to say, I'll have an E, please, Bob, but I'm sure that wouldn't be that original, would it?
Is this Bob Holness? No, will you turn around now? No, funnily enough, that's not Bob Holness, and I suppose this must be.
I suppose it must, yeah.
It's the one and only Bob Holness! Yes, Bob!
there was one quote where you said it was the National Service was very good for you because it made you tolerant of other people, which I'm not at all.
Aren't you?
And no, not in the slightest.
I better be careful, then.
No, not you, but just some people, you know, it just happens. And it made you channel your aggression, which is my problem when I'm interviewing people. Often people say, oh, you're a bit aggressive and you're not that tolerant. Shut that! I've done loads of films as well.
Because all your question of your partner was, who did you
say? Well,
I
was actually just about to ask you about the LA riots, because you live in LA. Surely that had a big effect
terrible.
On you.
It was terrible.
You were probably shagging someone at the time. I shouldn't imagine.
I'm an aggressive sort of character. I wouldn't try and change you, Mark. It's not my business, is it?
Just the way you spoke to me then, I feel a lot better.
Do you? You feel better?
To be honest, yeah, I feel a lot softer.
You remind me of that cartoon character.
Oh, thanks.
Tintin. You know that guy?
Oh, yeah.
You look just like him, right? Oh, you know, man. I mean, it's just the way your little hair is shaped.
Hey, thanks, Dave. Really nice to have a new nickname for the new series. Thanks a lot.
The Word.
Christmas just wouldn't be Christmas without something to tap your tootsies to. And here's just a handful of some of this year's musical high spots. Here's Stone Temple Pilots with Sex Tightening.
Freaking realistic there with Cootie Rider. We'll be rapping more festive tunes later on with Onyx, Hole and Stackabo. But first, a polite introduction.
Dim the lights, boys. Hold your breath. And ladies and gentlemen, prepare to be dazzled by our new presenter.
Ooh. My name's Hoofty and I'm the brand new presenter on The Weird. And I'm having a cushy time. They gave me the job on three conditions. I get a long blonde wig, I lose 3 stone, and I pretend to be a Mancunian. So, back to you, Danny.
Well, Hoofty, you've been broadcasting live to the nation now for about 20 seconds or so, and I think we'll get you off on the right foot and give you a bit of advice. Terry?
Oh, a bit of advice for Hoofty. Yeah, what I'd say is don't let all the cash the freebies, the foreign travel and the press attention let you forget where you come from, because with an accent like that, no one else will.
And here I am in Bopu, Tatswana, or Bop, as we say after a couple of pints. I've been personally invited here to Sun City for Miss World 1993. Could you show me how to do it?
Sure, okay. Your left leg is going to point straight forward.
Right.
And your right leg makes kind of a T behind it. You want to bend the left knee, but keep your legs closed, don't forget. Shoulders square to the front, tuck your tummy in, shoulders back, head held high, big grin.
Is that
I think you got it.
Now, a lot of the girls are over 6 foot. They've got long hair like yourself. Do you think there's any chance for a short baldy like me?
Absolutely.
If you keep your hair longer, you can be a Miss World.
The Miss Worlds are very, very glamorous. Do you think there's a much chance for a short baldy like myself to have a go?
Well, why don't you come and join the pageant?
That's a great idea. I'll do that. Ta-ra!
The following information on star-sensitive stories is for operational use only. Ralph Harris, a name known to us all except Samantha Fox.
Ralph or Ralph? Ralph.
Oh, it's Ralph. Don't call me Ralph. I go mad. I go into a mad mode if you call me Ralph. Hate it.
Ralph, didn't you actually do
Ralph?
That?
Ralph? In trouble. Ralph?
Ralph, then.
What if I called you Sam or Sim or something?
All right, Ralph, then.
Ralph?
Ralph, then.
More Dimbo than Bimbo. Separated at birth. Tina Turner. Nora the Troll.
Yes, we got an early Christmas present this year, something we were happy to share with you, a brand new member of the Word team.
Here you go, Terry, son. Have a mince pie.
Hey, thanks, Austin. If that's... I think the only reason that took you on was to make me seem a bit posher.
Cheers, Terry. The Word only secured me services because we get all the biggest stars in the world, and we get them first. Last March, Danny went to Florida for the first British TV interview with America's hugest celebrity, Shaquille O'Neal.
Forget Michael Jackson, forget Arnold Schwarzenegger. The most sought-after interview in the States at the moment is with Shaquille O'Neal.
O'Neal runs the floor, takes it all the way!
And I've come to the Orlando Arena, home of the Orlando Magic, to try and battle my way through the throng to try and grab an interview with the man who fills this boot. Shaq's size 20 boots have helped him slam dunk a fortune of £60 million in 5 months. Rookie Shaq has just turned 21. He's dating 21 Jump Street star Holly Robinson.
I've trained my gun on how many guys?
And he's already achieved the impossible by replacing the legendary Michael Jordan as America's favorite and richest basketball star. And he has single-handedly transformed longtime no-hopers, the Orlando Magic. They paid him £28 million, but they are now championship contenders.
Shit! Shaquille O'Neal for the jam!
I managed to get him on his own to find out how he measures up.
Did you ever consider playing for New York or LA, one of the bigger teams?
I thought about playing for LA, but when I considered how much, you know, trouble it would be, I said, nah, I'll stay here in Orlando. I'm happy with my team. I'm happy with the decision that I made. I ain't no joke, now I slap
my jammer and make sure it's broke. But when I asked him about his rock and roll aspirations, Shaq got a bit shirty.
Is there any kind of future in a music career?
I don't know.
Why did you do it then?
Why did I do it?
Uh-huh.
Because I wanted to see how I was. I wanted to see how I could do. And I called those guys and put a song together. It sounded pretty good. I might be coming out with a record. I might not.
That moody manner doesn't stop him being America's hero. Once they all wanted to be like Michael, now it's Shaq.
You see this 12-pack right here? It's going to be called Shaq Pack.
29-year-old Jeff Stryker is porn's first superstar. His 14 smash hit videos have sold 2 million copies worldwide. Last year, he modeled for Terry Mugler with Sharon Stone, Dolph Lundgren, and Sandra Bernhardt. Jeff is a new breed of porn star who says fulfilling people's fantasies is the ultimate safe sex.
I've come to see Jeff's private parts, his Hollywood hideaway, that is. Let's find out if his hospitality is as warm as his pants. Hi, Jeff.
What?
Okay, what did you see in Jeff that made you think here is a star?
Well, he had the combination of three things. You can figure that one out, right?
What's the combination? Spell it out.
Face, body, and crotch.
That's my baby.
It's your baby. Now, this dildo was actually modeled on your personal boy stick.
Yeah.
Did they approach you, the company that made this, did they approach you to do this?
Yeah.
And were you flattered?
Yeah, I was.
There it goes.
Mine doesn't make as much noise.
You've made a career in both gay and straight films. Are you gay or straight?
I'm me. And to each person I meet, I'm someone else. And I'm something different.
There are times when things actually go too far when you're filming.
When I go too far, they usually go, ah, no, 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 God, you've gone too far. It's just half in. Now relax. I keep telling you. Lay back, relax. The other half won't even feel.
Whether gay or straight, one thing's for sure, Jeff's one heck of an actor.
The Word.
Coming up after the break, more weird and wonderful Word Christmas presents with Jamiroquai, some studio party games, and the big fight with Nigel Benn and Chris Eubank.
The Word.
Where will the 1994 final of the Words Mr. University be held? Find out after the break.
Spread the word.
I did that.
It was nice of her to do that.
Someone else did all that.
I didn't know they did that.
I'm glad they don't do that.
At Thompson, we spend 52 weeks a year making your 2 weeks perfect.
You get people who come to be seen, you get people who come to see, you get people who just use it as their local. What I tried to do was apply all the techniques of French cuisine into producing a higher quality of English cuisine. Fish and chips, bangers and mash. A lot of our regular customers, I would say 90% of them, have the American Express card and use it. It's putting bums on seats.
American Express is welcomed at Langan's and other entertaining restaurants.
At Red Mountain, we know what a compact source of flavor the coffee bean really is. So, we seize beans at their freshest, then squeeze them over and over and over again until we well and truly captured that fresh, invigorating flavor. Red Mountain. A taste of stimulation.
Pressure from blocked sinuses can cause pain and headaches. Take Sinutab. Its double action eases the pain and relieves congestion quickly. And new Sinutab Nighttime is now available to also aid restful sleep. Sinutab and Sinutab Nighttime relieve sinus pain and headache fast.
Glencoe turkey, plum pud, brandy butter, and burgundy. Alka-Seltzer, for fast relief from headache with upset stomach.
15 years ago, I personally became a member of American Express. I let the restaurant try it out first.
To apply for the card, simply pick up this leaflet.
Now, here's a unique opportunity. Own your own chilled premium lager in rich gold and frothy white. Brewed in the traditional method by genuine German craftsmen, it comes complete with this stylish glass carrying case and a guarantee that all the sugar is turned to alcohol. Don't delay. Buy one today.
Because more people want to do it with Thompson this summer, we're doing even more free child places. So if you're going to do it soon.
We asked you, where will the 1994 final of the Words Mr. University be held? The answer is...
It's Mr. Swansea!
Yes, in Swansea, the University of 1993's winner.
The Word.
And welcome back. Later on, we've got music from Stackerbow and some head-to-head banter with Nigel Benn and Chris Eubank.
But first, we've got some Christmas games that you shouldn't try at home.
It's shaming people with extreme stage antics like this that has given Peter Powers the title of Britain's wildest hypnotist. At 27, he's no longer the youngest, but is he still king of the watch swingers? Tonight's challenger for the world's hippest hypnotist is Alex Leroy. The son of Tizzy the Clown and Marianne Montana the sharp-shooting cowgirl, Alex started his showbiz career at the age of 3 as Flap the Clown. By 8, he'd done his first hypnotism. Now, aged 18, he's Britain's youngest mind-bender, and he claims the most manipulative.
So, Alex, if you want to start, show us exactly what you can do.
I'm only talking to you if I touch you on the shoulder. When you wake up, you've got a red card in your hand, and you're the referee at a football match. You've got to send the other players off because they've done something really awful. You won't accept any shit from them. You three, when you wake up, you've been sent off, and you know it's the end of your career if you get sent off, so you're going to plead and beg, and you really don't want to be sent off. One, two, wide awake, everybody, wide awake.
How many times have I got to tell you?
You are not worth that! Get off, I'll despise you! Sit down! Sleep!
There's your apple, take a nice big bite now. There's your apple, take a nice big bite, enjoy your apple. Open your eyes, you can eat it. You've not played very well at all, you've lost. You have lost your concentration, and that's because somebody has stolen your willy. When I count to three, you'll be wide awake, and you'll realise that Mark has stolen your willy, and he swapped it for his little teeny-weeny one, and you're bloody furious, you want it back, you really lose your temper. You'll not be violent. One, two, three, you're wide awake.
Mark, you bastard! Give him back! I want him back now! Give him back!
Earlier on, we hypnotised a member of the audience to believe that he was this American superstar.
Like a virgin.
Ooh.
Touched for the very first time.
I've noticed you are sporting a new look. Is this a Gaultier look?
Well, what I'm doing, I'm getting ready for the London Marathon, and I'm going in drag. I'm going to go as a man this year.
And I ought to say that we did hypnotise a member of our audience into thinking they were Madonna, and you've actually come out of it now, haven't you, mate? How do you feel about that?
Great, really happy I've done it. And, I'm sure the offers are going to come in every minute now.
Picking up play after half time, Alex Leroy got more from his squad than Graham Taylor ever did.
Wide awake! The more noise they make, the more you take off. The more noise they make, the more you take off. That's it, take it all off. That's it, the more you scream, shout, sing.
Alex, we'll leave it there.
The match is finished.
But it was Peter Power's special early bath that won the day for Britain's king of the watch swing.
When I count to three, you'll be wide awake, and right in front of you, you'll see a bath full of clear water and your favourite shampoo. You're going to climb in, you're going to enjoy it, and have a very nice bath. One, two, three, you're wide awake. There's your bath. The final goal has been scored. The final goal has been scored. You're going to celebrate, throw your arms around them, kiss them and cuddle them, just like they do when they win the final goal. And Mark Lamar has scored it. One, two, three, you're wide awake. You'll wonder what the hell you're doing. You will not splash beans around, you'll take it very calmly. One, two, three, wide awake.
Welcome to the hopefuls, people who said they'd do anything to get on television. 23-year-old Todd was born on Canvey Island and works in insurance. His ambition is to be a lifeguard on Baywatch. So we provided Todd with a 77-year-old babe who certainly needs the kiss of life. In your own time, Tom.
I'd do anything for TV. Anything.
Good luck for the future, mate.
But it wasn't just the boys who shared their party pieces with us. The girls also had their moment of glory.
The women behind me are having their breasts measured. And you might be wondering why. Well, the reason is the man standing right next to me, it's Michael Stivers. He's come all the way from Florida. He's a qualified surgical hypnotherapist, and he claims to be able to increase women's bust measurements in a matter of minutes. So, Michael, how do you actually do this?
Well, it's a matter actually of increasing the blood flow to the breast region. And that's all it is, really. And the fatty tissue feeds off the blood flow.
Uh-huh.
And that's all it is. And we'll pump up those puppies in about 15 minutes.
So presumably you have to hypnotize them first to pump up those puppies.
Right, yeah. I'll talk to them for a few minutes and then that's it.
But what are your aspirations for tonight?
Couple of cups bigger.
Couple of cups bigger. You are a 36 double D, we see.
Yes.
So aren't you just being a little bit greedy here?
Well, breast is best.
Breast.